the increase in temperature due to climate change will mean we have a greater number of very hot days. Those hot days will lead to older people having stress on their heart, stress on their lungs. Heavy rains will have an obvious impact in flooding, but a less obvious impact in that they'll increase the amount of allergens in our region. Increased allergens, increased temperatures will lead those with asthma to have more asthma attacks. And for those who don't have asthma, they could develop asthma in unusual parts of their life.
We'll see increased heat-related deaths. We'll see increased heat-related illness, such as heat stroke. We expect to see more cardiovascular diseases, more respiratory diseases, more deaths from things like drowning, and increased carbon monoxide poisoning from the improper use of generators, more waterborne and foodborne gastrointestinal illnesses, increased asthma, as well as changes in the patterns of vector-borne diseases like West Nile virus and Lyme disease.
One thing that happens is that increased temperatures will lead to a higher level of what's called ground level ozone. Many of us have heard of bad days to go outside if you've got lung problems. Those lung problems are often caused by either ozone, a particular component of oxygen, or increased particulate matter from smog. So increased temperature increases the ground level ozone and increases the impact of all the pollution that we know is out there on vulnerable people specifically, but really everyone's ability to breathe.
In regards to heat affecting public health, we're concerned about the most vulnerable people in our population. The young, the elderly, the infirmed, they are disproportionately affected by heat and temperature.
One of the connections between climate change and infectious disease has to do with contaminated water from heavy rain events. Then you have runoff, you get combined sewage overflow, you can get contaminated in drinking water wells, so that can produce gastrointestinal illness.
During periods of heavy precipitation, we find that an increased load of bacteria on our beaches. So basically it becomes a risk to our bathing beach community and our tourists in that they might be exposed to a higher level of bacteria because of the flushing out of the storm drains and the storm sewers and so forth.
New Jersey's infrastructure is such that heavy rains and heavy storms takes down power lines, disrupts transportation, makes it difficult for people to move between their homes and hospitals. It has a particular impact on the elderly, the homebound elderly, or people that need medical equipment like breathing machines.
We also expect to see increased mental and behavioral impacts from stress related to extreme events and concerns over climate change.
In regards to mental health, we found that during Hurricane Sandy, a number of residents in New Jersey were adversely affected by climate change. We've seen some of the data that shows that there have been increases in mental health illness, increases in depression, increases in drug use and abuse. So we feel that more detail and more effort needs to be taken to look at the mental health component.
Part of what public health is trying to say is climate change is something you really need to worry about. It's not just another one of the thousand things out there. This is what a big one, perhaps the big one, for the future of health in the United States and in New Jersey particularly.